The Uganda People's Congress Party President Jimmy Akena has praised the Makerere University Vice Chancellor Barnabas Nawangwe for shining a light on the potential of Busia District through education. Akena also challenged leaders to address issues concerning youth unemployment in the country, saying that they should be given adequate skills to earn a living. He was addressing mourners during the send-off of Ignatius Okello Wegesa Wata, who has been the Busia chairperson of UPC and a lecturer at Makerere University Business School.
Has shown the way. Vice Chancellor Nawangwe has shown the potential of Busia. But we must make sure that future generations and the young people have every opportunity to excel in this country. We have a challenge which has brewed in Kenya, but it's also here with us. The young people need to be given the correct knowledge and skills to be productive in this society.
Akena also reiterated the Prime Minister of Owenengo Bwabugwe Culture's call to improve public service in the country.
The health services have a lot to be desired. In many cases, we go to our medical facilities and we do not get the treatment we deserve, or we don't get the medicines. I personally believe that the greatest asset of the citizens of Uganda is its people. The people of Uganda are the greatest asset which we have, and we must do everything in our powers to make sure that those citizens get everything they deserve.
Rafat Egesa, the Prime Minister of Owenengo Bwabugwe, thanked the mourners, especially the Busia District Local Government Council, for paying tribute to Egesa and encouraged the family members to remain united. Nawangwe, who is also a brother to Egesa, thanked the mourners for coming in huge numbers. The Executive Secretary of the Uganda National Examination Board, Dan Odong, described the late Matthew Bukenya as a workaholic, disciplinarian, good listener and God-fearing. Odong, who expressed the board's condolences to the family, recounted the achievements attained by UNEB during his 20 years of leadership. Among the achievements were acquiring a printing press, embracing technology and issuing results via SMS, among others. Bukenya's career at the helm of UNEB began in 1997 when he was appointed as the secretary, a role he held until his retirement in 2016. His 19-year service marks him the longest-serving secretary in the board's history. He succeeded David Livingstone Ongom, and before Ongom, the position was held by Basil Chuanuka. UNEB was established in 1983. Bukenya was recalled out of retirement in 1997 to head UNEB, where he previously worked as an accountant. At the time, UNEB was struggling to counter examination malpractices.
But we had some unfortunate events in 1995, which caused the suspension of the senior staff of UNEB, including the chief executive officer at the time. So Mr. Bukenya was recalled from his retirement. He had just started his leave, pending his retirement at the end of 1995. So the board recalled him to come and lead a caretaker administration while the board carried out investigations into the unfortunate events that occurred in 1995.
Bukenya and his team managed to significantly reduce the leakages by introducing changes in the setting, management and marketing of examinations, including concealing the names of examiners. Bukenya died on Sunday night at the age of 89 after battling health issues. Political decisions taken this year will determine whether a target to end AIDS as a public threat by 2030 can be reached, the United Nations said on Monday. Figures from 2023 show a drop in new infections and fatalities and improvement in access to treatment for HIV-positive patients. But while those figures look positive, the UNAIDS agency warned that the progress remained fragile. In the over 4 decades since the AIDS epidemic burst onto the global scene, it has killed more than 42 million people. While AIDS-related deaths have been steadily declining, falling from 670,000 in 2022, to 630,000 last year, the numbers still remain dizzyingly high.
The data shows progress. 9 years ago, only 47% of people living with HIV were on treatment. Today, that figure is 77%. So a 30% increase in getting people on treatment in the last 9 years.
Nearly 40 million people live with HIV, the virus that can cause AIDS, the report said. Around 1.3 million new infections were recorded last year, a decline of 100,000 compared to 2022, and a dramatic 60% fall since a peak of 3.3 million in 1995. But the long-term trend is still way off track to hit the UNAIDS target of just 330,000 new infections in 2025. Access to antiretroviral medicine has also greatly improved but remains a major issue. Last year, a full 30.7 million people received such treatment compared to just 7.7 million in 2010. But it remains unlikely the world will manage to hit a target of reaching 34 million by next year.
But the world is not on track to end AIDS by 2030. A person dies from HIV-related illness every minute. It's still a crisis.
Byenyima stressed the need to dramatically scale up access.